Our work consists of the assessment of indicators describing phenomena associated with climate change.
The study was carried out in collaboration with the National Observatory of Athens in the framework of the BRITEC program.
In particular, we studied the differentiation of the thermal sensation indicator in relation to different locations and their characteristics, as well as to the characteristics of the 18 students who participated in our campaign.
Then, we studied the phenomenon of the urban heat island using measurements provided to us by the National Observatory of Athens through the comparison of three different locations, an urban, a semi-urban, and a suburban.
I am Flora Paparou. I am a science teacher at the First Upper High School of Lilisia in Athens. During the past school year, we had the opportunity to work on a Bringing Research into the Classroom project titled Urban Climate and Human Bioclimate. Apart from me, Marina Korisoidi, a teacher of social studies, was involved in the coordination of this project. 18 students of the first and second grades of the school participated in it. The students were free to choose if they wanted to participate in the project or not. The project had three different phases. The first phase was the presentation of its content to the students by Dr. Christos Giannaros, a researcher at the National Observatory of Athens. The second phase was a citizen science process. The 18 students did scientific measurements with the help of the researcher. The third phase was a statistical analysis study. Three students of the first grade undertook this task, and their study took the form of a paper for a student conference. Here you can see the first phase of the project. Dr. Christos Giannaros explains the project to the students. He informed the students on the phenomenon of climate change. He particularly explained the impact of climate change in urban climate. He highlighted the importance of citizen science for the research of the effects of climate change phenomenon, and particularly for the estimation of the relationship between urban climate and human bioclimate. Here you can see the second phase of the project, the measurements. With the help of a pocket weather meter provided by the National Observatory of Athens, the students, guided by the researcher, measured air temperature, relative humidity, wind speed in different locations, in the classroom, in a sunny or shaded place of the school courtyard, in a sunny or shaded street, in a sunny or shaded place of a park. The degree of cloud cover was also estimated and registered in the six outdoor places. In parallel, the students used a questionnaire created by the researcher to register personal information concerning their age, clothing, body type, and skin type. They also registered their activity, for example, standing, walking, etc. Finally, they registered their subjective thermal sensation. This was repeated in each one of the seven different locations. Thus, two different types of measurements, objective and subjective ones, have been used to identify the thermal conditions in each one of the seven different locations. The measurements again. Here you can see the objective measurements in the seven different locations. And here you can see the subjective measurements of one of the students in the seven different locations. The third phase of the project lasted from December 2019 until May 2020. Zmirni Luisa, Rizioti Vasiliki and Kourdakis Nikolaos did this study. The students used the registered data to form appropriate indicators and compare the microclimate and human bioclimate characteristics of the 7 different locations. They also compared their results with measurements describing climate characteristics in 3 different places in Athens, an urban and semi-urban and a suburban one. This data was offered by the researcher to the students in order to draw their attention to the urban heat island and effect. The students became able to link the microclimate characteristics of the 7 different locations of their study with the urban heat island effect.